What is good, y'all? Welcome back to yet again another upload. You dig what I'm saying? It's your boy J.I. and I'm back at it again with another banger for you guys. Now, in today's video, you can tell by the title and the thumbnail, today's upload is basically gonna be mapping out the build plan for this car, man. I get this question literally all the time. All the time, people ask me, J.I., what you gonna do to the car? J.I., what's the plan for this thing? What's coming next? What can we expect? So, with that being said, man, I decided, let me just go ahead and drop an upload for you guys, telling you guys where I'm at, kind of with the build and what I wanna do to it. So, with that being said, I know if you guys have been in the loop with all the videos, then you guys would understand, well, would have already seen. Idiot, that's what the fuck you get for not letting me go through, dumbass. Look at this shit, man. So this is clearly a turning only lane, and this dumbass nigga wanted to scoot up and not let me through and shit, and now his ass stuck because his stupid ass thought he could go straight through this. How the hell you gonna go straight through that? That's clearly a turning lane. But hey, man, you know what I'm saying? Karma, what goes around comes around, you feel me? Karma is a bitch, you know what I'm saying? That shit's stupid as fuck. Now I'm stuck here because this dumbass nigga wanna be fucking stupid, bro. Move the fucking car, dumbass nigga. Makes no fucking sense. Fucking idiot. Fucking dumbass nigga. Makes no fucking sense. Stupid ass nigga. Anyway, back to what I was saying, y'all. So, with today's video, man, we're basically going to be breaking down what I'm doing to Reaper, you feel me? Now, if you guys have been in the loop with all the uploads, I actually dropped a video talking about whether I was going to be staying NA or if I was going to be boosting Reaper. Now, with that being said, I kind of have decided I am going to go NA for a little while, but I definitely want to boost him. I'm just not 100% sure what platform I want to go with as far as the boost goes. Now, I do know that I want to go supercharger or pro charger. I don't really care for the turbo builds unless my boy Miguel 5-0 can definitely change my mind about them. You know what I'm saying? We definitely got to get a ride along very, very soon. Cause he got a twin turbo 2018, if I'm not mistaken, 10-speed auto. That joint is a monster. It's got a parachute on the back and everything. That joint's crazy. So definitely got to get a ride along with him. Maybe he can persuade me to go twin turbo kit from Helion Performance. But as of right now, I'm really leaning towards going either Paxton supercharged or going Whipple. Now, I definitely wanted to go VMP Gen 3R for shit sure, but the only thing with that is I'd rather have them do the build on the car versus myself do that install, just because, one, it'd definitely be a great experience to go out there, see the shop, meet the guys out there, and then, you know, have the car tuned on that glorious outside dyno. You know what I'm saying? That would definitely be crazy. But as of right now, I'm not 100% sure if we can actually get that set up with them and whatnot. Who knows? God willing, maybe in the next couple of months, you know what I'm saying, shit'll be a little different. And, you know, who knows? Maybe they'll reach back out to the kid and we can set something up. But that would definitely be dope. But for this, you know what I'm saying, for NA, let's go ahead and talk about it. I'm definitely gonna go ahead and go full Botons with this car. So I'm going headers, cold air intake, E85, full exhaust. I want to go Corsa on the exhaust just because Corsa, they really make some of the best exhaust systems for this car, especially their Corsa Extreme. Oh my God. They should really change the name of that exhaust system from Corsa Extremes to Corsa She Screams. You feel me? Because, bro, with Corsa, oh my God, man. Like, I know you guys have seen, you know what I'm saying, the Stings that are paired with the Corsa full, even if it's just a catback exhaust, you feel me? It doesn't even necessarily have to be the headers and catback. It could be separated headers from like a different company, like Cooks or something like that, paired with Corsa Catalyst. Bro, them joints are nasty. And as of right now, this is just not cutting it, y'all. You know what I'm saying? It's not cutting it for the kid. y'all know me. If you guys have been around for a while, then you guys know all of my cars have been loud. Even my V6, like, I gotta be able to pull up to a function, you know what I'm saying, and be like a couple miles, not even a couple miles, let me stop the count, be like a mile out or so, or a couple yards back, and people already know, oh yeah, J.I.'s pulling up, you feel me? With this car right here, as the sound system sits, as the exhaust system sits, bro, you really can't tell when I'm pulling up, you know what I'm saying? Like, it sounds good when you're on throttle, but like, as far as like downshifts and stuff like that, and sitting at idle, you can barely hear it. So with that being said, I'm definitely going Corsa for the exhaust. I really want to go Corsa full, like the headers, the catback, and everything, full Corsa system. So if any executives from Corsa are watching this right now, hey man, let's work something out. You know what I'm saying? JI Corsa collab. I know I wouldn't see it. You know what I'm saying? So let's work something out. Shoot me in the DM in the on IG, man. You know what I'm saying? We can definitely set something out, man. For sure. You feel me? But with that being said, yes, man, I definitely want to go Corsa for the exhaust, long tube headers, catless, of course. What are cats? What are cats? You feel me? But anyway, I want to go Corsa for the exhaust, and then I definitely want to go ahead and go PMAS cold air intake with the Boss 302 intake manifold ported, of course. I was debating on going with the 18 manifold ported, but I just feel like I've heard mixed reviews, bro. I heard that it's a good intake manifold, but I've also heard that if I was to really want to go big power, the Boss 302 manifold is way better. So I'm kind of stuck in between those two intake manifolds. I definitely want to go NGW short throw shifter. As you guys know, I've complained about how far fifth gear is from the rest of the gears for the longest, so I'm definitely going with that. I'm also replacing my clutch. If you guys haven't seen the most recent video, man, make sure you guys go tap in. But this clutch, the clutch chatter is just ridiculous. It sounds like the car is knocking and I can't deal with it. Give me 1 second, y'all. I'm about to go grab my food.
1 hour later.
All right, y'all, got my food, you feel me? But anyway, like I was saying, so yeah, man, I've heard mixed things. I've heard that the Boss 302 intake manifold ported. Oh, hell nah, boy, we do not need no damn copyright, boy. What the hell wrong with y'all? Anyway, I've heard that the Boss 302 ported intake manifold is just better all around. It's a better unit to go with. So I'm probably going to be going with the Boss 302. Now, if you guys have any, you know what I'm saying, information that suggests otherwise as far as the 18 Manny goes, definitely go ahead, drop it down in the comment section down below, because it's the whole reason why I'm making this video. You know what I'm saying? Just to, you know, tap in with y'all and let y'all know, you know, exactly what I'm going to be doing to this car. I'm definitely putting this car on E for sure. Coyotes love E85, you know what I'm saying? It's known. It's just like, you know, boosting that joint, you feel me? At the end of the day, coyotes just love E85. Now, I know corn burns way faster. I think it's like 20 times faster than premium does. But I mean, I'm at the gas station every other day anyway. Like, when I had Mamba, I was definitely at the gas station at least 3 times out the weekdays, you feel me? Like, it was legit bad. So I'm not expecting anything different as far as this car goes. I'm pretty sure once I get to modifying it for real, it'll definitely start to drink as well. So with that being said, I'm not tripping on that. So let's go ahead and get a little revamp, because I'm only going to tell y'all what I'm doing to the motor, you feel me? I'm not finna get into details about the exterior cosmetic mods. Now, y'all know how I get. And I'll leave you guys with this one single hint. Every time I start up a video, I throw up my Instagram like this. So the color of the Instagram always ties back into what I do with the car. You know what I'm saying? So just peep that if for future references, bro. Especially with the tags on the car. The color of the lettering and stuff like that on the car always ties into what I'm doing with the car. So that's all I'm gonna say on that, man. Just know this joint is gonna be nasty as far as the motor goes, as far as cosmetics go. It's gonna be a different beast for sure. So with that being said, let's go ahead and reiterate everything that we're doing to the motor straight off the rip. Just a quick recap, and then we'll go ahead and close out this video. So as far as the engine goes, we're going full bolt tons, intake manifold, exhaust manifolds, full cat-back exhaust. So this straight pipe life is definitely getting tossed away. If you guys are interested in grabbing this joint, you know what I'm saying, I'll probably have it up for sale. Also, I have my Flowmasters up for sale right now. Get at me. They definitely work for the S550. They have the S550 tips on there, but you might be able to get away with putting it on an S197. I'm not 100% sure. Just get at me in the DMs on Instagram, and we can definitely chop it up. And yeah, man, that's probably it. Now, as far as like porting goes, I might do a ported throttle body. I might do an upgraded throttle body, maybe get something a little bit fatter just so we can get some more airflow going to the motor. I also heard Cobra Jets. Now, Cobra Jet, I ain't gonna lie, them Cobra Jets definitely do make a difference. I'm on the fence, man. I'm definitely on the fence as far as the Cobra Jet goes, just because, bro, them joints they up there in price, bro. You feel me? They low-key be taxing on them Cobra Jets. So I completely forgot about that. I have looked into those a little bit too, man. So who knows? Maybe we go Bosch 302 intake manifold for a little while, run that setup, see what we can run at the track, and then get tired of it and switch to the Cobra Jet. Or maybe we just go straight Cobra Jet. I'm not 100% sure yet. But that's where I'm at as far as the build goes for the motor, man. Now, the exterior, y'all already know I'm not going on bags. Y'all already know I'm already lowered on Eibach lowering springs. So with that being said, it's only a couple more things I can do to, you know what I'm saying, the outside of the car. And I ain't even tell y'all about the interior, man. I'm telling y'all, I'm finna tee up. So with that being said, if you haven't already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and turn on those post notifications. I'm telling you right now, you're not going to regret it. Again, turn on the post notifications, hit the subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up, drop a comment in the comment section down below. You know what I'm saying? That's all I need y'all to do. And like my boy Back to the Money says, all of that, all of those things I just asked y'all to do is free. And they literally take 0.5 seconds to do. I ain't even gonna cap. You know what I'm saying? So with that being said, y'all, that's actually gonna wrap it up for today's video. That's the build plan for Reaper as far as the motor goes. Who knows? Hopefully I can, you know what I'm saying, link up with the boys down there in Florida and get that Gen 3R put on this joint. That'd be crazy. You know what I'm saying? But we'll see. Like I say, that's gonna wrap it up for this video. I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace.